Okay, hello everyone. I want to welcome you. It's very nice to see all you guys and girls here in this morning. It's incredible to see how this community has grown. Yeah, when we started with Agile Greece in, I think, 5 years ago, it was like 5 people, 10 people maybe in each meetup, and now you have dozens of people in each meetup, and we have this Agile Summit every year where hundreds of people gather. Yeah. Okay. So I want to spend some minutes. So in BEAT, we are the platinum sponsor for the third year, and I want to spend some minutes to explain why we do that, why it's important for us to support this community, and why it's very important for us to see this community grow. So, first of all, who we are. If you don't know BEAT, it's a ride-hailing app. It's very similar to Uber and Lyft. And our mission is to make people move fast and efficient throughout the city. We started in 2011 as a very small startup. We were 5 people back then, and we operated as a startup for maybe 4 to 5 years. And we were very happy if we did, I think, 100 rides a week. Right now, we operate in five countries. We're almost 800 employees, and on August we did 18 million rides. So we are going well. Business is going well. We're growing. And I want to state here that a large part of this success is Agile. And Agile is kind of embedded in BEAT's DNA. Why is that? Well, we operate in a very chaotic industry. The urban mobility, as it's called, is a really chaotic industry. No one knows what is going to happen in, let's say, 2 years from now. You have all these electric cars and smart cars and autonomous cars and now the scooters. No one can make plans. So the only way to navigate through this chaotic situation is Agile. And what is Agile? I've seen many definitions over the years, and I've myself used some of them, but I very much liked the definition that John Kern, one of the authors of the Agile Manifesto, gave right in this building, I think 1 year ago it was. Agile is all about quick feedback. That's the essence of it. The more you can get quick feedback in a chaotic environment, the more and use this feedback, utilize this feedback, the more easy it is to you to make the right decisions. So I want to just display to you how in BEAT we try to do that beyond product development, because in product development it's kind of established in many companies. So this is the case with our Amsterdam hub. I think 2 years ago we identified that we need a new technological hub outside of Athens. The Athens hub right now is around 200 people, but we needed to target talent, especially in machine learning and artificial intelligence. So we identified Amsterdam for that. And the project was frozen for many reasons, I think about 2 years, and in June we said, okay, we really need to finish this project. So what did we do? We sat in a room and discussed it and made the 6-month plan. No, we didn't do that. We took a plane to Amsterdam. Really, in the next day, me and the CEO and some other guys took a plane to Amsterdam. Why? Quick feedback. We landed there, and in like 2 days, we have gathered so much information. We learned about the ecosystem, about the companies that operate there, about the 30% ruling, about everything. So we had feedback. And after that, we went home and we created the backlog. And we said, that's the things we need to do in order to deliver the Amsterdam hub. Find a director of engineering, find some backend developers, find an office space. And then we assembled a cross-functional team that was about to deliver on that backlog. So that's the team. This picture was taken actually yesterday for this summit. So there you have some engineers that were going to do the hirings. You had some HR people that were going to work with the legal staff, Comp and Ben. It was a really cross-functional team. And on that team, we established some light ceremonies, like you did a stand-up, we did a retrospective every week to see how we're going. So the team actually delivered. We find some backends, But then there was this case with the director of engineering. So that's me actually on the phone when I was listening to him. So what happened is that I was doing the interview with the director of engineering, and I liked the guy. And after the interview, he told me, well, I don't know, you've not been briefed by the agency, right? I said, no. He said, well, my company is shutting down. We're a small startup, around 25 people, and funding is out. So we want to go somewhere to work as a team together. And my eyes were like, whew. So you have these guys that have been working as a team. They're good together. They have backend developers, UX designers, front-end developers, whatever you need. So again, the first thing we did is we took a plane to Amsterdam. Literally, the next day, I assembled a small team of people that could assess these guys in Amsterdam. And again, the reason is quick feedback. Why wait? Why do all this interview process that takes weeks? We went there, we assessed the team, and fortunately, we spoke the same language. We had kind of the same engineering principles, like the DevOps culture and Agile culture. They worked on microservices, so it was very close to us. So we hired, not all of the team, but many people from the team actually joined, and now we have a strong office of around 20 people, and this happened in like 2 months. So if you put what we did here, it's actually very similar to what we praise to do in Agile. So you have a need, and then out of this need, you create a backlog, and then you create a cross-functional team that could burn this backlog, and then you apply some processes there, some lean processes, and then what you want is quick feedback. So, for example, we didn't make a plan, because the usual way to open office is you find a director first, and then you find engineers, and then you form the team. But we said, okay, if we find the director first, we will do this. If we find the team first, we will do that. So it's planning and not plans. The last thing I want to say is my personal failure on that, because I didn't do Agile. I didn't practice Agile. When I started working on the project, I myself created a technical roadmap from the Amsterdam team. So, they will work in this kind of microservices, and they will do this and that. That happened around June, and the team assembled on August, so it's 2 to 3 months. I did a great work, nice work, I admired it, but it was not relevant at all. It's useless. Why? Because I didn't have the feedback. When the team was assembled, they looked at my document and they said, you know, you write all these things very well, but we don't need that. For example, we know how to build microservices, so that's not the focus. We don't know how to build machine learning, so we should work on that. That was a lesson for me. I'm still learning. So that's all for me. Again, thank you for joining. We have a booth right outside that you can ask questions. We're hiring. We hire both in Greece and Amsterdam. You can go to our webpage, thebit.co/careers, and we hire product owners, product managers, scrum masters, engineers of all kinds. We're really growing. There's also a game that you can play, the Agilometer, something like that you can test your Agile knowledge. And another thing, I don't know if you know that, is that all of you may have a concord here. That's mine says Agility. And if you meet or find the person that has the same, you go to our booth and you win a prize. And it's actually a prize for both of you. So it's kind of pair winning. So thank you and enjoy the conference.